spinal cord injury part 1 in this video I'm talking about the classification of spinal cord injuries, paraplegia, quadriplegia. In order to understand the spinal cord injury, one must have the fair idea about the tracts running through the spinal cord, so sensory tract and motor tracts. So any partial lesion of the spinal cord is known as incomplete, and complete transection of the spinal cord or complete lesion is known as the complete spinal cord injury. So injuries being classified into the two varieties, one is incomplete and complete. So the below injury, so the patient would lose all the motor or sensory and some of the autonomic functions, as some fibers runs through the spinal cord. So this is the pathophysiology of manifestations are followed by the spinal cord injury or below the injury. The classification of the spinal cord injuries are mainly by the American Spinal Injury Association, ASIA, classified into the A, B, C, D, E levels. Depends on the muscle strength. It also classified basis on the strength, the grades from 0 to 5, different grades. 0 means absolute no signs or no motor signs, and 5 is full strength. So in this video I'm talking about only the complete transections of paraplegia and the quadriplegia. The paraplegia means the off of the body paralysis. Plegia means paralysis. Para means off. Quadriplegia means quadri means four. Four limbs paralysis is known as quadriplegia. The main difference between the paraplegia and quadriplegia is the paraplegia involves on the lower limbs, whereas the quadriplegia involves in the both lower as well as upper limbs. The complete transection of the thoracic or lumbar segments would leads to the paraplegia, whereas the complete transection of the cervical segments leads to the quadriplegia or tetraplegia. So this is how the basic difference between the quadri and paraplegia can be seen in this illustration. The lower half of body is involved in the paraplegic situation, where the both arms and legs are involved in the quadriplegic situation. And the main causes of these complete transection of these spinal cords are injury or direct trauma in the sense sports related activity, and any automobile accidents and etc., direct trauma to the spinal cord, tumor and vascular related blood vessel blockage to the spinal cord supply, compression of the spine and decompression etc., and gunshots are the major causes of complete spinal cord lesion or complete spinal cord injury. And the involvement of different levels of transition or the lesions or destruction of the spinal cord, if the lesion occurs in between T1 to T8, so mainly the upper limbs are spared, and the poor abdominal and trunk muscle control is seen if the lesion occurs in between T1 to T8 thoracic segments. If the lesion occurs between T9 to T12, so the trunk muscles spared along with the upper arms or the upper limbs. Whereas if the lesion occurs at the C3 C4 level, that leads to the impairment of the respiratory the ventilation, because this phrenic nerve emerges from the C3 C4 level, which supplies to the diaphragm. Whereas if the lesion occurs below the C4, the respiratory system may be spared. So however, the signs and symptoms of this spinal cord transition is purely depends on the extent of the damage to the spinal cord. And this is what about the complete transition of the spinal cord at the paraplegia and quadriplegia, and the complete spinal cord transection or